You know, a lot of people bought a PlayStation 3 for Final Fantasy 15. Then it was called Final Fantasy Versus 13. That was a whole 10 years ago. This game has been in development for a long time, and I can really tell that Square Enix cares about this game. The developers, they treated this as a passion project. A Final Fantasy for fans and first-timers. I fall into the second group. I would consider myself a first-timer. I played a few of the originals, but this Final Fantasy in particular, I was really curious about. Whenever I can sniff out a game that I can tell is a labor of love, I pay attention to it. It piques my interest. And before we start our adventure, I'd like to thank Square Enix for gifting me a code for Final Fantasy XV. I've seen the trailers. I haven't seen Kingsglaive. My Blu-ray is still in the process of being shipped, but I'm really excited for this journey we're about to take. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the world of Final Fantasy. Nah, I already did the tutorial, so I'm not going to go through that. I've played a little bit of this game. I'm not virgin, not completely, but I haven't played too much. From what I have played, I can really tell that this game is something special, and I wanted to save the rest of the adventures for us today. I'm going to be doing this video a little differently than our usual videos. It's just going to be really chill, just enjoying the experience that is FF15, and I'm going to be talking exactly 0% during the cutscenes. Anyway, let's get started. Final Fantasy 15. In a time unknown, only a prophecy keeps hope alive in people's hearts. When darkness veils the world, the King of Light shall come. Now four brave warriors begin their journey, prepared to fight. What awaits the four, however, they do not know. The Tale of the Chosen King, Savior of the Star. Before the fall.
The decreed hour is come. Set forth with my blessing, Prince Noctis.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Take your leave. And go in the grace of the gods.
Right.
Well, princes will be princes.
So much for royal protocol.
Not like you had to deliver a formal address.
Your Highness!
What now?
I fear I have left too much unsaid. You place a great burden on those who would bear with you.
You're one to talk.
I ask not that you guide my wayward son, merely that you remain at his side.
Indeed, Your Grace.
We'll see the prince to Alticia if it's the last thing we see.
Yeah, what he said. Hate to break this up, but Kor's got the motor running. Drados, he's in your hands.
And another thing. Do mind your manners around your charming bride-to-be.
Your Majesty as well. Try to mind yours around our esteemed guests from Niflheim.
You have no cause for concern.
Nor do you.
Take heed. Once you set forth, you cannot turn back.
You think I would?
I need only know that you are ready to leave home behind.
Don't know about you, but I'm ready as I'll ever be.
Take care on the long road. Wheresoever you should go, the line of Lucis goes with you. Walk tall, my son.
A bit of explanation in the story before this one. It's a story of two empires at war. Niflheim, and of course, the one that our prince hails from. This is them trying to make peace. Chapter 1, Departure. Prince Noctis Lucius Callum sets forth from his homeland with his three men down in tow. His destination, Alticia, capital of Accordo, where he will formalize the union of states through his marriage to Lady Lunafreya of the imperial province of Tenebrae. Now, keep in mind, I'm a bit new to Final Fantasy, and hell, this is a new story for Final Fantasy, so words like Tenebrae, you know, I'm going to do my best to pronounce him, but I'm anything but a native. We're playing Final Fantasy XV, fam. If you guys are just joining up with us now, you're in luck because we haven't started our adventures. In fact, we're just about to. As soon as it finishes loading, which I don't know when that's going to be. We are playing on the PS4 Pro, by the way.
We can forget about hitching our way there. Thought people were friendly outside the city.
You can only count so far on the kindness of strangers.
You're just gonna have to push her all the way.
I've already pushed myself to the brink of death.
Get up. Come on, car isn't gonna move itself.
Jeez. I thought the car was supposed to move us.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Can it? Ready, steady.
Push!
In the graces of gods, my ass. The king couldn't even give us a car that works. Although this is looking nice. Look at the speckles in that paint job. Well, road trip is off to a great start.
Not exactly a fairy tale beginning, huh, Prince Noctis?
We let ourselves get carried away.
Look! These things happen.
Let's just hope this isn't some omen.
Gladio, do me a favor.
What?
Push this thing by yourself.
All by myself?
You won't even notice if we just let go.
Prompto, don't even think about it.
Save some breath for pushing.
Ignis, come on, time to switch.
Nuh-uh! We just switched back there!
And it's my turn, Noct.
His turn.
My hands are killing me.
You rather I kill you with mine?
Easy there, tough guy.
Any luck?
Only a busy signal.
Hold the phone. Is it just me? Or was it supposed to be way closer?
I assure you, the map is correct.
The map said Hammerhead was right there.
Literally, next door.
Looks that way.
on a map of the world.
The world's a big old place,
filled with wonders.
Tell that to my legs.
Are you guys even pushing?
Hard as I can.
With everything I've got.
Final Fantasy 15. I wouldn't want to be the one pushing that heavy car. You see that thing? That car, it's not made with plastic, let me tell you. Final Fantasy World's made with metal.
Hey there, y'all kept a girl waiting. Now, which one's the prince? Aha! Hello, Your Highness. Congrats on your wedding.
Not hitch just yet.
Lady Lunafreya's groom-to-be, here in Hammerhead.
Apologies for taking so long.
You best save your apologies for Pawpaw.
Well, that makes you...
Cindy. Sid's grease monkey granddaughter.
Roll her in while I'm still young. Didn't your daddy tell you? She's a custom classic, not some beat-up old clunker. Prince Noctis.
Yeah.
Prince. Like they took your old man and kicked the dignity out of him.
What?
You got a long way to go, son. And that slackjaw is getting you nowhere fast.
She's gonna take a while. Y'all get her in and run along.
Y'all heard him. Let's get moving. Right this way.
Now we play the waiting game.
Never liked that game.
Never any good at it either.
Outpost Hammerhead, huh? May as well do some exploring. Got enough time.
Y'all ain't never been out this way before, have you? Go on, have a look around. This'll make sure y'all don't get lost.
That's nice of her. Got a world map for free. That's pretty generous. A world map, that's gotta be a lot of map. Visit the local tipster to gather information. Sure.
Well, might as well make good use of the extra time.
Yeah, Gladius is the right idea. I'm gonna call him G. Hey.
Oh, they got Ebony out here. Oh, Ignis is gonna flip.
Wait, what's a gill?
Look at that. It's a sword wagon.
Take a look at our wares.
Earn gill by completing hunts or by selling trinkets you find. Well, we haven't found any trinkets yet, but these... Damn, look at that shield. Wow. Looks nice. Ooh, yeah, okay. We can't even afford that. We don't even have 150 gil. We have zero. Although, I got my eyes on those swords. War sword especially. I'll be back. Wait a second, look at that! Look at the bottom of the screen. We got little old-school Final Fantasy pixel versions of each of our party members in it. That's what decrees who can use what. Looks like we can use everything, which is pretty sweet.
A moment, Noct. We've expended the last of our funds on the repairs. I suggest we confer with Cindy.
Broken down and flat broke.
Adding insult to injury.
The Pauper Prince. Well, Cindy said earlier that we were Lady Luna's groom-to-be, not the other way around, so looks like Luna's getting the short end of the stick with this marriage. Prince Noctis and his royal set out to sail for the neighboring land of Accordo, where the prince is to wed his... Never mind. I thought maybe we didn't necessarily run out of funds. I thought maybe we ran out of funds that they accept. They accept gil, but well, the guild, you know, that's the currency of choice, but they accept all currencies. So we actually did run out of all of our money. Legit, everything is dry. So, I guess we may as well earn some gil. The king, you would think, would have given us plenty of cash for the journey.
After charging us that much.
Yeah, let's pay him a visit.
It's a nice looking tow truck. Alright. This is a really rough start to a road trip, but let's see if Cindy has any work for us.
She ain't gonna be ready for a while. Y'all need something?
Yeah. Money. Ooh, that's gonna be tough. Not gonna ask for a loan, that's just weak. Not gonna ask my friends to solve this for me either. Only one option here. She's not gonna like this.
Bit steep for a simple tune-up, don't you think?
Oh, now I get it. This must be what Papa meant when he said he was gonna teach them boys a lesson. Told me he ought to have y'all take care of some ornery varmints that have been causing a ruckus around here. I'd be happy to pay y'all for your services if you're up to the challenge. How about it?
Well, so much for finding an easy way out. Thanks a lot, Papa.
Alright, cool. We got some ability points. This is a JRPG, by the way, if you guys haven't played a JRPG before. Which I, to be honest, I really haven't. I played a little bit of... Is Bloodborne really even considered a JRPG at this point? Or even Dark Souls? That's as close as I've come, aside from the older Final Fantasy titles. But I've always actually been a huge fan of the UI of JRPGs. I think it's absolutely beautiful. Now that seems useful. Reduce the MP cost of phasing. Definitely. That leaves us with a paltry 2 ability points, which we can't spend on anything. I guess it's time to move on.
But don't go running around after dark. The demons are liable to rip y'all to shreds. Here, this ought to be enough for a place to stay. Just between us, though. Don't tell Papa.
Cindy gave us 1,000 gil. I don't know what the conversion rate is, but 1,000 gil, that seems like it's...
Ignis, we're going.
On my way.
Seems like it's going to buy us a pretty fancy hotel. And this looks like a bunch of red scorpions in the Mojave Desert. Alright, so I don't know if scorpions are particularly dangerous in Final Fantasy, but...
Looks like we found our first targets. Ready, Noct?
Ready as I'll ever be. So one of the awesome things about Final Fantasy XV is the fact that you can teleport or phase to where your blade is. Check this out. Yeah! Alright, so far so good. We got one of these guys down! That leaves just 2 more. Piece of cake.
Excellent work. On we go.
Of course, we got 2 more. By the way, guys, this is actually running at 4K on the PlayStation 4 Pro, downsampled all the way to 1080p for the live stream, and we are streaming this at the highest bitrate possible, so you're not going to find a better-looking live stream of Final Fantasy XV, and I gotta say, this is a nice-looking game. Really appreciate the graphics, but what goes beyond graphics for me, I don't know about you guys, but art style is primarily what I'm into, what I'm looking for. If a game has solid graphics, that's great. But without a solid art style, it just doesn't have that magic. I've always been a fan of Final Fantasy's art style. I really, really like the music. And this is delivering in spades. I really need to watch Kingsglaive. That's kind of like a prequel movie. Feature length, by the way. It's 2 hours long. It's a great companion to the game.
They aren't gonna know what hit them. Let's do this.
It's a lot more scorpions. Alright, let's go for it. I'm gonna have Prompto start it out. If I can. Press square to roll dodge and definitely evade enemy attacks, and yeah, I already know all this. Crap. I can't actually have them attack for me right now. Oh, there we go. Nice! So, I don't know if you've been able to tell, but team play is pretty huge in Final Fantasy 15. And we got our bros right here. We got a road trip party. We got three awesome guys and, you know, one little pauper prince. But these guys are pretty good at what they do. And they're extremely loyal to yours truly. So whatever we tell them to do, they're going to get on it. You see that blind side? That was a ton of damage dealt to that scorpion thanks to the fact that one of our teammates helped us out. Excellent. There's two different ways that you can play Final Fantasy 15. I'm deciding to go for the real time. It's kind of not, well, it's not really like Devil May Cry, but if you've only played Devil May Cry, if you haven't played any other Final Fantasy games or JRPGs or anything like that, I guess Devil May Cry is as close as it gets to this style of gameplay. When Noctis runs out of MP, he enters stasis. Yeah, if we're not careful, Noctis is gonna tucker himself out. He is just a little prince, by the way. You know, he's just a little pauper. He can't do too much by himself. So what I'm trying to do is run like a little girl and point warp away. Crap. There we go. That's gonna allow us to regen a little bit of our energy. Nice. It's the best way to do it. Retreat.
We'll be done in no time.
Focus your energy in. And then attack from a distance when they least expect it. Alright, 600 feet away. It's the final den of scorpions. But I just really appreciate the...
where are we headed anyway?
Nowhere until the repairs are done. Then we head for Golden Key.
Then after that, we hop a boat, and before you know it, lover boy's hitched.
Wait for car repairs, then wedding bells in the air. Got it.
If only it'll be that simple. I don't know. After playing years and years of video games, I just don't trust like that anymore. Especially since this place looks like the Mojave Desert. I've been double and triple crossed many, many times in that desert. Anyway, I appreciate the fact that Final Fantasy decided to kind of go in a bit of a new direction while still sticking to their guns. This is definitely, apparently, very traditional Final Fantasy, but you don't have to go with real-time strategy if you don't want to. You don't have to go turn by turn, although you can go for more of that style.
We got a little problem over here.
Cool. We'll take care of it.
You also got this. So far, so good. Yeah, like I don't know about Warp Stripe. These guys think I am. Somebody that doesn't read tutorials? Excellent. The effects just look so damn cool. It's really heartwarming to think that this game spent 10 years in development. The developers were just so keen on making a game that, beyond all measures of cost, was going to be a good game, a good title for Final Fantasy fans and newcomers. I mean, a lot of companies, a lot of publishers, they probably wouldn't have cared about pushing it out ahead of time, you know? Before it's even finished.
Who could this be?
Nice. Mission.
Hello?
Hey, it's Cindy. How goes the hunting?
Actually, we just finished.
That's great, because I got one more hunt for y'all. Only this time, it's for a person. Fella named Dave went off, and we ain't heard from him since. Reckon he staked out a spot in an old shack nearby.
Old shack? Oh, got it. We'll take a look.
Your owl's all afraid it's gonna be another type of hunt.
Needs us to find some Dave guy.
He went missing?
Not missing. Said he's holed up in that shack.
Mutant Dualhorn Sighting, codename Bloodborne, characteristics Red Tusks, extremely violent, outstanding bounty on Saber Tusks in the area. Yeah, this sounds like something we're about to go investigate.
Locked! Get out of here!
are now.
Spoke too soon. I'm going all out. Just don't.
Oh! Holy crap. So we got a bunch of demon dog things and oh my god, I can't even see. All right, we got to get out of this shack. I have a feeling I know where that missing person went. He's probably scattered in all these different little bellies. Little tiny demon dog bellies. Yeah, let's run. They got us boxed into a corner. That's not good odds for anybody. Crap. My friends aren't following suit. If they don't leave that hut, I can't either. We can't just leave them behind.
The shack over there.
Oh. Didn't think there'd be two. Well, maybe he still is alive. As long as there's no demon dogs in this one as well. Wait, what is that? Oh, yeah. Yeah, those are demon dogs. He's dead. I'm sorry, Cindy. This guy you're looking for. I'm not gonna find anything but pieces of him. Oh, great. We'll see if we can sneak around. Hit him when they least expected.
Not yet. I've got a plan.
Alright, Ignis. Not a bad plan. I warp to the windmill.
What are we looking at?
This creature is known as a saber tusk.
And then I use a warp strike.
Its tusks, extracting game from the safety and comfort of burrows.
That's a bit heartless.
Yeah, don't think we'll be befriending.
Nice surprise strike. They didn't see that one coming. Oh my goodness! Oh, these things are nasty looking. Yeah, I don't like these things. It looks like a 20-day-old corpse of a dog reanimated with tusks. You know what it looks like? It looks like if you made a mutant saber-toothed tiger, killed it, reanimated it, and then mutated the reanimation. That is some serious necromancy looking stuff. You know what it also looks like? Crap, we're in stasis. We gotta warp out of here. It looks like something for the Witcher.
Hey, who's out there?
Well, and look who's in here. The man of the hour.
Dave, right?
Been looking for you.
Didn't mean to cause y'all any trouble. I've been stuck here on account of my sprained ankle. Yeah, something funny about them varmints. I gave them hell, but couldn't finish the job. Still one mean mutt about. Well, y'all don't look much like hunters, but what do you say? Put that puppy to rest for me?
Yeah, let's do it well, we really need the money. Ah, hell. Doing a job for money is what mercenaries do. Not princes. Princes hire someone else to do it.
Oh, yeah. We'll take care of it.
Well, you all got guts, that's for sure. Let me tell you where I last saw him.
Way to show some spunk. Now let's get ready to kick some tail.
Magic flask, huh? Is that like a never-ending flask of booze? The Mutant Marauder. Alright, let's locate this pup. He's a little further out, isn't he? Wish the car was fixed.
It would be wise to rest up before we set out.
A formidable foe awaits. Prepare for this encounter by resting at the nearby haven. Ignis will cook a status boost. Hey! Say no more! Yeah, you got it, Ignis. It's a good idea.
In that case, let's find a spot to make camp.
The hunters are really out in full force around here, huh?
So they're the new Crown's Guard or something?
Similar, though technically a civilian outfit.
They've definitely seen a lot more action than we have.
Is it cool that we rock Crown's Guard outfits?
Be worse not to. They made them especially for us.
Even got a sweet insignia on them.
In the Crown's Guard, your attire identifies you. So wear it with pride.
I mean, they are pretty badass. I gotta say, these costumes look awesome. If someone made them in real life, they'd probably look silly as heck, but in a video game, with video game logic and video game physics, it's pretty styling. In fact, you could say it's sizzling. Really? That's our camp? You know, that kind of looks like... You remember that place where Frodo and Sam and... I can't remember if Pippin was Pippin with him? I think he was with him. Anyway, they made camp on this little rock and they cooked bacon and then ringwraiths came after
them. Sometimes I wonder if we'll ever sit inside that beautiful car again.
Sitting most of the day was pretty nice.
Napping was even better.
And here we are.
Speaking of sitting and napping... Camp at Havens to enjoy a status... Yep, I know about the meal. I know about the meal. Let's camp. We don't need to train.
All right. I'm gonna pitch the tent.
Oh, yeah. So, one of our awesome fan members, Mayu, sent us a little tip. You see that little area, the little canyonous area just above the Three Valleys? More specifically, just above the T and the H. There's a fire longsword directly in that area. Before we set out for the pub, before we hunt, we're getting that sword. Yeah, we could skip the Hobbit love. People are getting nervous. Don't worry, guys. It's just, you know, it's just Japanese clothing. That's it. A lot of leather, though. Awful lot of leather. Cozy little camp. I like it. Oh, are you kidding me? I get to choose the recipe? Sweet. Whoa! Wait a second! Whoa! Is that Coleman? Is that Coleman camping equipment? What? No way! No! No! Siri, listen. I gotta find out if this is true. Hold on. Coleman camping equipment.
I didn't find any matching places.
Oh my god! Oh my god, Siri! Fine, I'll use Google. That's real camping equipment, right? Am I imagining things? This would be like if they just crack open a can of Mr. Coffee in Final Fantasy. Or if their car was a Camaro. Coleman. Yes. Yes, it is. That's a real brand. Oh my god. Wait a second. I searched Coleman on Google and it just pulled up images of a bunch of oil-up beefcakes. Coleman Lantern. Yeah, that is a real brand. I wasn't going crazy. Ah, how crazy is this? All right, back to the recipes. Ignis uses ingredients to prepare meals at camp. Acquire new recipes to expand Ignis's cookbook and the variety of bonuses available. You know what? Is it wrong that I'm not even worried about the bonuses? I'm just worried about the food? Flame roasted toast. Is that just burnt bread? What else we got? Toasty rice balls. He likes toast, that's for sure. Croquet Madame increases attack by 30. Ooh. I think we should go for the attack boost. Yeah. Problem is, yeah, let's not go for this attack boost because we only have 2 bird beast eggs and 1 gigi and 2 gigi ham, and I don't know how much it takes of either. Let's just go for a nice basic flame roasted toast. Like he came up with that idea. I came up with that idea. I am the genius that is flame roasted toast. Man, that's one hell of a meal. Tell you what, that'd fill me up for a whole day. sticks to your ribs, flame roasted toast. Almost sounded like Pokemon. Alright. We have 16 ability points. I didn't even realize that. Nice. And we're already up to level 3. Looks like the most anybody learned was Prompto with photography. Oh boy. Ignis didn't learn anything cooking some burnt bread. Prompto is documenting the journey in photographs. Review the pictures he takes and save his best snapshots. You know what I've always wondered? Share snapshots on social media and show your friends. Wait. Did they mean like real life social media, or is there Final Fantasy social media? That's not a flattering picture. Oh my god. Now, that however. Yeah, let's save that one. Yeah, definitely. That's pretty cool. It's a nice natural moment. In fact, let's share this one. Wait, is this real social media?
No! Don't share that!
That would be weird. That's a pretty cool one. We'll save that one. Is there gonna be like a scrapbook in the credits that's gonna make me cry after we all, you know, we're all dead? Or maybe Noctis is alive and his brother's dead?
Pretty good. I know. I dig it too.
What, this one? Alright, I'll save it. That's pretty badass. A little too much man ass. Cute. Little scorpion buddy. He doesn't like it, but I'm definitely saving it. Alright, looks like that's it.
Like a father to her.
Ever since they got back, Cid's been the only one looking after her.
Rather more than a middling mechanic can handle.
All things considered, I'd say she turned out okay.
Well, like any girl. You just need to treat her right.
Treat her wrong and Cid'll stuff his wrench where the sun don't shine.
Take care of the car and it will take care of us.
Yeah, the car.
Yeah, I don't think that last idiom is exactly true. Alright, I think we're rested up enough. Let's get up and at him. We got a pupper to kill. Not a sweet pupper, we got a demon pupper. That's the okay kind to slay. That's a bit of a distance. Hopefully we remember to bring everything from camp. Actually, you know what? That magic flask, by the way, it had nothing to do with booze. We're not going to be drinking on the job. It had to do with magic and spells and potions. Which means we may as well collect some of this elemental energy on our way. Elemency, fire, ice, and lightning magic. Luckily, this stuff just grows. It doesn't grow on trees, but it grows on rocks, which is the next best thing. Eos has tons of it. Let's pick up some fire before we leave. And let's also grab that fire sword before we forget. Alright, not bad. These effects look so good. By the way, aside from playing on the PS4 version, or the PS4 Pro version, we're also, playing with the PS4 Pro advantages, like the fine detail, highest resolution, around 4K. And that is where we're gonna go. Unfortunately, you guys won't be able to see HDR, although there is HDR in the game. HDR is just... it's not visible unless you have an HDR television. It's one of those things where it's a display technology. Kind of like if you have a 144Hz display and you watch 144fps video, or you play a game at 144fps, you can see the difference, but
it's
you can't
so
see the difference on it.
Walk. Our Crown City upbringing didn't prepare us for this.
Pretend you're walking to the car.
Yeah, man, that's not gonna fly. No. Just not the same. So this is apparently where we're gonna find a fabled fire longsword. Yeah, there it is. I recognize the bones. Really pleasant music. Almost sounds like the Shire. Oh shit. Didn't stay pleasant for long.
We got a little problem over here.
Cool. Go take care of it.
Alone? That wasn't part of the deal.
Alright, we got some demon doggos. The further we are away from, the more powerful this is.
Damn, I love that warp strike! Ooh, that was not a good block. Thank you for saving my ass. Alright, let's fall back a little bit. I'm gonna have one of my teammates engage him. Not a bad shot. Alright. Let's warp away and then let's warp back. We had to learn to block a little bit more. Combat's actually really, really fun. Beautiful leg strike. Thank you, Prompto. Yo, Prompto seems to be the most helpful in these battles. You'd think it would be G-Man. And he's the one with a huge double longsword. Crap, we're in stasis. We're gonna be no help in stasis. Let's get out. I can't. Need some backup over here. Anybody? Thank you, Ignis. And finally, we're in safety. So we're not just gonna lose HP. We're also gonna lose maximum HP if we're not careful. The only way to recover maximum HP is to rest yourself at a camp. Well, actually, no, not even a rest, I don't believe. I believe the only way to recover maximum HP is to use an elixir, which luckily we have one elixir and we have some potions as well, which we don't currently need. We will soon. There's a heck of a lot of demon dogs. I would say this is more than a pack of them, too. This is an absurd amount. Alright, we're about to go in stasis. Let's get out of here. As long as they don't dogpile us, we'll be okay. Nice, 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 nice. Alright, it'd be in our best interest to take a little bit of a potion. Let's fall back and recover. Back in the tip-top fighting shape. Let's take these guys out, once and for all. Alright, so far so good. Getting some nice dodging and as long as they can't touch us, they can't hurt us. Alright, that's more like it.
That was a close one.
Too close for comfort.
I'm comfortable just being alive.
I like that report card feature. Turns out we actually didn't do too shabby. Now where's this sword? Oh, that is just gross. I don't know if I can zoom in, but you see that mouth? Oh, that's nasty, man. It's like a dying, decaying Venus flytrap combined with a clicker from The Last of Us. Hey, there it is. Alright, let's equip this thing. I don't know if I'm gonna use it or if one of our friends is gonna use it. You know what? Let's be selfish. Equip Noctis and his friends with... Yeah, we already know that stuff. Alright, Noctis. Got yourself a brand new weapon. Wait, that's not it. There it is. A great sword with fire in its core. Foes vulnerable to fire, best beware. I hope those demon dogs are vulnerable to fire. Guess we'll find out soon enough. Alright, now we've got one heck of a journey ahead of us. And sadly, we don't have a car for it. Yeah. It's actually not quite as far as I thought it would be. I mean, it's almost double the distance from any of the other adventures and little hunts that we've had, but still, it's not going to be too tough. Massive, can you stream Far Cry 4 next? Unfortunately, I don't think I'm going to be streaming any more Far Cry 4. We streamed the entirety of Primal, though.
Got plenty of time to figure it out.
Funny thing about time. You never have as much as you think you do.
Over there! That's it, right?
Huh. That's a dual horn?
Yes, but not your run-of-the-mill breed. We'd best make quick work of it.
Jesus. Looks like something out of a Hideo Miyazaki movie. Is it just me, or does that kind of look like it's infected with whatever was in Princess Mononoke? Alright, I have an idea. If we warp to that tower over there, Ignis style, just might be able to surprise it.
Wait a sec.
What? Scared, big guy?
You ought to be too. Thing's vicious.
You sure? Looks tame to me.
Yeah.
Look out!
Nice one.
It's not over yet.
Ready for round two. Bring it.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about this. All right, Ignis. Oh, boy. Oh, my God. I'm going to have Ignis take the first strike. Here we go, here we go. Nice one.
Think we're in for a fight.
We got more than we bargained for.
Alright, we gotta figure out a plan of attack. We're safe as long as we're in cover. Alright, while we're in cover and our teammates aren't, I'm gonna have Gladius take him down, rough him up a little bit. That's a pretty sick move. That is definitely the best move, though. Getting around in the back of this guy seems to be a pretty good strategy. His horns are obviously very dangerous. Excellent. This should be the... Ah, shit. Nope, not quite, not quite. Oh, God! His butt is his weak spot. We gotta go for butt shots. Sweet. All right, Prompto. Finish him off. I like that gun, man. Yo, we just dogpiled him. I almost feel bad.
Ring, ring.
He doesn't look right.
Hello?
Hey, Dave just called and said he's safe. Thanks for finding him.
Ken?
Nice work, y'all. By the way, the old girl's looking good as new. She'll be waiting at the garage.
Gotcha.
You hear that? No more walking.
So, who's up next behind the wheel?
Ignis should take it and never let go.
It helps that he can keep four eyes on the dash.
I couldn't even keep one.
Not sure I'd do any better.
Put me in the driver's seat. Good. Because I need the legroom in back.
Nah, that's just selfish. I don't know why kids would always want to call shotgun. Personally, I'd be glad when they'd call shotgun. Back of the seat, back of the car. That's where you want to be, especially if you're tall. Which I guess Gladius is the tallest one, so, Gladius, you deserve it, man. Besides, you carry that big heavy sword around all day. You whack beast with it. Good in my book.
Man, it's hot.
Then lose the jacket.
He doesn't take any bullshit, does he? For those of you wondering, yeah, this is an open world, the first open world Final Fantasy. That's not an MMO anyway. Of course, I've heard rumors at the end of it's linear, but I don't see any problem with having linear in a game as long as it suits the narrative. Damn, this is one hell of a walk. Let's start sprinting. I don't know how these guys stay so pale. Their sun must be a hell of a lot different than Earth's. Maybe Eos' sun is just less harsh, because these guys look really pale. Even,
It's rude to keep a girl waiting. You better apologize.
Wait, what?
What is that? A large hurricane. That thing's like half bird, half storm, half airship.
You realize that's three halves.
That would explain its size. Awesome in every sense.
Wait, what was that? Is it not gonna attack us? It's just a giant bird running around? Okay, let's get back to Cindy. By the way, Prompto, you don't need the interrupts to tell me to do what I'm currently doing. We're currently getting back to the car. Jesus, man, hold your horses. Look at that. Those mountains look awesome. I'm actually really happy that this is kind of my first, like, in-depth playthrough of a Final Fantasy title. I'm going to play this thing from front to back. I've played a few others, mainly the earliest ones, the NES era, or SNES era. I enjoyed them. Never finished them too much, but this is just... I'm really liking it. I can't even quite put my finger on it, but it's great. The music especially. But yeah, to answer your guys' question, this is open world. And apparently it's a very, very large world.
Stinking hot. Indeed.
Yeah. I bet I can guess who's stinking hot. Gladiolus! I mean, look at that guy. Looks like something you'd see hanging up in a meat locker. He's just one big, massive hunk of beef. Although, he does have the area shirt. Well, actually he does. Look at that. He's got short sleeves. Doesn't have anything under it. The rest of us are pretty clothed. We at least have something under our jackets. Alright, we have two choices here. Either we go to Cindy, and we don't keep her waiting, or we get a bite to eat in the diner, which is what I'm gonna do right now.
Welcome.
That face does not match that voice. Welcome! We got plenty of food over here at the Tacus Pit Stop Diner!
Order away.
Oh yeah, man! Jambalaya or chili? I'm gonna go with jambalaya. Wait. Increase maximum HP by 200? How much is this? This is expensive. Oh my god, 700 gil. So, Cindy gave us 1,000 gil as a way to afford a place to stay for the night because we're flat broke. 700 of it for a meal. That seems really expensive. What about this? 50 gil. Alright, that's more my budget.
You got it.
Oh yeah, here it comes.
Damn, that does look pretty good. Do I have to choose who I give it to? Or does it give it to everybody? I think it gives it to everyone. Awesome. Wait a second. Is Ignis stealing his recipe right now? All right, looks like we're done here.
What do y'all want to know?
Oh, awesome. I got a new rule from now on. Before we leave a shop or anything like that, we first ask the man if he knows anything. Oh, there's a bar around. Bars know everything. And pizza delivery places. If you want to know that the neighborhood's good before you move into it, just ask a pizza delivery place if they deliver there. If they don't deliver there, don't move there. Simple enough.
Alright. Had your fill? Good.
We kept Cindy waiting long enough. Ironically, we kept her waiting by eating some food at the diner using her money that she gave us for a hotel.
What is it?
Wait, check what out? I don't know what you're talking about, man. Is he talking about... I think that's our rest stop in the distance that we got a marker on. No, that's the mark we made before. Let's go ahead and remove that marker to avoid any further confusion and ignore whatever he was talking about. I didn't even know it had a roof. Look at that. Fancy.
Sorry about the wait. Ain't she pretty?
Oh yeah.
She's almost too pretty for the road.
She's back! We should all get a picture with her.
All the more reason to ride with care. Oh, and before I forget, would y'all mind making a little delivery for me?
Well, shit, she did give us 1,000 gil, and she asked nothing of us for it. Let's do it.
No, not at all.
Perfect. Thought you'd say yes. So I already put it in the trunk. There should be a motel on your way to Galden. If y'all wouldn't mind giving that to the owner, that'd be swell.
Grandpa like grandkid.
The pauper prince, the errand prince.
All polished up and ready for the road. Would you care to take her for a little test drive, Noct?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Sure, why not?
And I needn't remind you to exercise caution.
Yeah, of course. I'm totally not gonna peel out of this place and open her up. No, I'm gonna drive like an 80-year-old woman. That's exactly what he looks like he would do. Pauper prince, errand prince, dandy boy prince, and now... speed demon prince. He's got a need for running an errand at a perfectly safe speed that adheres to the rules of the road. Wait, what's this? Oh, what? Wait, oh, I thought you could choose automatic or manual depending on what you wanted the car to be. That would have been incredible. Select a destination, have your Ignis drive you there. Manual, drive the car yourself. Okay, so this is just a little menu. Let's drive it ourselves.
Time to go.
All right.
Are we getting crazy with this? Roof goes down, party goes up. Wow, this thing's smooth. Oh, I'm not driving it yet. I guess that explains that. Now I'm in control. Alright, well, we're gonna drive to the rest area and do this errand before we can actually get along with our mission.
You know?
One would expect no less of purveyors to the crown.
I'll miss it once this road trip's over with.
There's no reason you can't pay them a visit anytime you please. I'm sure Cindy will be glad to look after your car. Oh, right.
So, that's what this is about.
If you need, I could always lend you the regalia.
Whoa! Thanks for the offer, but once we're back in the Crown City, I think I'd better score my own wheels.
Visit Hammerhead to have Cindy install new parts to upgrade the regalia's performance. I hope that we don't lose this car in this game. If this car is destroyed, it's gonna hurt. Wait, we have gas? We can run out of gas? That's great. What's the navigator? Ah, it's just the GPS. Let's put on some music. Yeah, that's more like it. Alright, looks like we're almost there. Can't turn in there. I guess that's not an entrance. Oh, there we are. Jesus, I look like a student driver. Which I guess I kind of am.
Cindy never said a word about what was in the package. How come?
Perhaps she couldn't say.
Girl's gotta keep her secrets safe.
And what would you know about those?
If I told you, then they wouldn't really be secrets anymore, would they?
Come on, just tell me!
Oh, we have to press X? There we go. You can't turn into it, you have to select it and then it turns into it for you. Autopilot easy mode.
Well, I'd say that's far enough for today. Might be wise to leave the driving to me until we found our bearings out here.
Yeah, you're probably right about that. Ignis will not drive when demons are out. It looks like we gotta drive manually at night, because he's got a little phobia on his hands.
Y'all came all the way out here to deliver the goods. Well, thank you kindly. We'll take it out of the trunk, so y'all just sit tight.
Umbra. Bringing us stuff. Attaboy.
A dog can really track a scent.
Certainly knows how to find us.
How do you always know, boy? Just a sec.
Nice flower. It's the same kind we sewed our crowns from. Oh yeah, sill blossoms.
So, I have a favor to ask. Take the notebook with you when you go.
Sure.
That's not all. I want you to put something in the book and send it back.
All set. Take care out there.
I know. You're not gonna tell me.
Then don't ask.
What was that about? You don't say.
Now that our work's done, let's see ourselves to Golden.
I don't know. It's a nice looking diner over there. Crow's Nest Diner, what's that say? The nest you can always fly back to. Yeah. People are certainly gonna come back here just for that diner. Wait, is that a little crow mascot? You'll look both ways before you cross a road. It's an old adage that Final Fantasy invented.
See that over there?
What about it?
Saw a Magitek trooper the other day.
Let me get this shot.
You read my mind.
Love the lighting.
Sweet. I like that photos feature. That's pretty cool. Yeah, that's not a bad looking car either. Guys, we got ourselves a little road trip going on here. This is beautiful. You've even got a little roadside food storage. Alright, what kind of food you got in that back of that truck? Oh, she's got potions. And food. Alright. It's kind of expensive. You know, for 50 gil, we got a whole meal. Still, I guess these ingredients are pretty hearty for what they are. Choco bean? A favorite of a certain big bird. Oh, choco bean! I thought it was like chocolate. Obviously it's not. I'm a little disappointed in that. And some music and paint jobs. We'll just stick with maybe some potions.
Thank you! Bye now!
Wouldn't mind buying some of the peppers in the back of that thing though. I like red peppers. Delicious. Alright, we don't need any more food. Let's get back to the car. I'm still gonna drive it. Oh, wait, I can't. Alright, looks like Ignis has to drive for us. He did recommend that he take the wheel next time. He doesn't trust us. And unfortunately, he has no reason to trust our driving. Alright. There it is. Let's go. Alright, what route do we take? We got a couple different routes here. Hammerhead, 1 minute. Oh, these aren't different routes. This is where we're going. Alright, got a 2 minute drive ahead of us, which is really not bad at all.
What's the forecast? Clear skies, with the temperature rising.
Nice.
So I'm guessing this is the game's version of fast traveling, but I hope that it's not like fast traveling, it's not a loading screen. It looks like he's actually going to drive us there in real time, which is pretty badass. Yep, I'm going to guess that's what's going to happen, that's awesome.
Formality.
One of those symbol of the peace deals.
So it's more like a marriage of convenience.
Her ladyship seems nevertheless amenable to the prospect.
And Noctier likes the idea.
What's that? I do?
Buzz off.
Wait a second. Is this the song Easy Rider from the Easy Rider movie? Nah, I don't think it is. If it is, it's a remix.
Hey! I see the sea!
I see it too.
That's Golden Key.
Kinda wanna go for a dip.
That a big mountain behind it?
No, it's an island.
Nobody goes to Golden for an island, though. They go to kick back and get massages.
And savor the seafood. It's famously delicious.
Sounds great.
Something to look forward to.
Is that the island we're going to? Because it looks kick-ass. Also looks like a giant upside-down ribcage. The car's coming with us, right?
Up on potions and stuff.
Nice. You're being helpful for a change.
What do you mean for a change?
Tell you what though, Prompto is really helpful in the field of battle. I mean, he's backing us up more than anybody else, and that car really... It needs a wash, and... a bit of a tune-up. And also, some of these dents to be buffed out. We really did a number on that poor car, though. I don't want to leave it.
Just got
a feature on the wedding.
And get a load of Lady Lunafreya's dress.
That's some fancy fabric work. Bet the groom can't wait to see it on his bride-to-be.
He's not the only one. Whew. She's gonna be an absolute knockout.
The dress is bespoke, of course, and comes courtesy of one of Altisha's foremost fashion designers.
Hello and welcome.
They said to stock up on potions, but this guy doesn't have too many. Elixirs are always good. Legendary energy drink that takes on superior restorative properties by way of Noctis' powers. Fully restores HP and MP, regenerates half of maximum HP. Let's get one of those. Sounds like a pretty good deal.
Thank you kindly.
We can afford to purchase a few more items, but I don't know if we need any more. Maybe some food, definitely, actually. Nah, we're fine. Let's get out.
We hope to see you again.
I want some of those barbecue chips back there. All right, let's get on the ferry. Man, I don't leave this car behind. Wait, can we go for a dip? Yes, I think we can. Look at that. We actually got stairs going down to the beach. What is this thing? Oh, chocobos. They're one of the famous things about Final Fantasy that I unfortunately don't know much about. They're cute though, I know that much. Wait, what's this? See that glint in the sand? Fossil shell. Awesome. Can we steal this boat?
Nah. So, you thinking a fairy tale, Lady Lunafreya, back to the Crown City?
Nah, no need to rush to happily ever after.
Wow. Still can't believe you're actually tying the knot, dude. How does it feel now that it's finally happening?
Fine, I guess.
Come on, you can't...
Maldacio Hunter HQ would like to remind you that in these troubled times, all of us must stand together to protect one another. We do battle with danger to defend the world we live in. Won't you lend us a hand? Drop in to see us at Hunter HQ, or contact...
Noctis seems pretty uncomfortable about this whole arranged marriage thing. Honestly, I can't blame him.
Take a shot from here.
Good call. Now it's picture time. Ready or not? Oh, love the lighting.
You like all the lighting, man. Though, to be fair, that is pretty nice lighting. Look at that. It's gorgeous. Nighttime. Fearsome creatures known as demons come out at night. Well, that's certainly gonna put some pep in my step. Damn, this looks like paradise. I just can't picture demons being around a place like this. This looks so beautiful. What's that? You see that in the distance? It's like some glowy rocks. Might be elemental rocks. What's this game about? Well, Jason Mills, That's actually... Wait, what can I pick up? That's pretty complicated. It's about collecting metal scraps, walking on beautiful boardwalks, driving cars, and demons. More specifically, there was a war. Almost a cold war between two nations. One of which, the nation that our prince hails from, the other. A nation of machines. A militaristic dictatorship, almost. They don't agree, they don't get along. But this...
Wow. This place is so romantic.
Then you get to enjoy it with us.
All three of us. You are a lucky man.
Anyway, this story is on the brink of peace. The marriage between our character Noctis and Lady Luna is supposed to bring an era of peace. Whether that actually happens remains to be seen.
Welcome to Golden Key.
I'm afraid you're out of luck.
Are we?
The boats bring you here.
What about them?
Well, they'll not take you forth.
And what's your story?
I'm an impatient traveler, ready to turn ship. The ceasefire's getting us nowhere.
What's this? Some sort of souvenir?
They make those?
What? No.
Consider it your allowance.
Huh?
Yeah. And who's allowing us?
A man of no consequence.
Yeah, right. Do you believe what that guy said about the port being closed?
I'm skeptical, though I won't discount the possibility.
I say we go check it out for ourselves.
My tummy's Suspicious stranger's pretty accurate. Suspicious, terrifying, rude, but also generous because he gave us a little bit of coin.
Welcome to the Mother of Pearl. What do you feel like having today?
Looks like what we saw in the distance was a camp. There's not a lot to do with this area that hasn't to do with the port.
We have a sumptuous selection.
Ew, the teeth are still in it. I guess this is the seafood he was talking about. It's not my thing.
Thank you for your patronage.
Well, the port's gotta be open. Unless there's some sort of a attack that we don't know about yet. We don't need to rest. Let's get out of here. I got a bad feeling about this guy. Although, maybe if we were smart, we'd wait until the morning. Oracle Ascension coin! Maybe that's what he gave us. Maybe he found one of those on the table. He could just be some crazy guy, you know? Maybe a town drunk, or maybe he's homeless, and unfortunately he has been bitten by a demon late at night when he was sleeping in the rocks. The Hexatheon, Titan. The Archean, steadfast as stone. Rama, the Fulgurian, sharp as lightning. Shiva, the Glacian, gentle as snow. Leviathan, the Hydrian, relentless as tides. Behemoth, the Draconian, unbending as iron. Ifrit, the Infernian, fickle as fire. Since time immemorial, they have watched over Eos. Where are they now? Where are they with this whole, Cold War business? I can't tell what's fantasy. I can't tell what's fairy tale in the world of Final Fantasy because magic does exist. Oh, it is out of service.
Out of service indeed.
Well, he was right about one thing.
Man, not a ship in sight. What gives?
Still though, even though he was honest and he was telling the truth, the way he said it makes me think that we shouldn't trust this guy. I'm gonna stick to my assumption, my first impression of him being a dangerous individual, no matter who or what he may be. I guess we gotta sleep. Actually, we just had a waypoint set for us, about 800 feet away. Go check it out.
According to my sources, the Empire, given strict orders not to let any vessels leave the docks of Altitia. Real shame if you were late to your own wedding. Right, Prince Noctis? Name's Dino, by the way. Pleasure. The Crown Prince of Lucis, bounty hunting in his fancy car. Surely you didn't think it'd go unnoticed. At least not by this reporter. Lucky for you, this reporter has integrity. If you want to remain incognito, I'll respect your wish. In exchange for a favor.
Is this a fast-talking, slick, Italian mafia-style reporter in a Japanese video game? This is what the Italian look like to the Japanese. Alright, shit. I will not be intimidated!
I don't owe you anything.
Wait, we mustn't rub him the wrong way.
Shit.
The sound of tacit agreement. Here. Marked where you need to go on your map. All you gotta do is find me some rough gemstones, like this one. Do this, and your ship will come in. Don't, and the papers will run you out of town. Capiche?
All right, pretty boy. Got yourself a deal. A gentleman's agreement, my ass. All right, let's get to the mineral deposit, and let's get this thing over with.
He's really got your number, Nox.
Not like we made much effort to keep it secret.
Even if we had, the press always finds a way. We needn't befriend him, but we'd best not make him our enemy.
As always, Ignis is right. Gah, journalists. Current year, journalists. Hate them. And, apparently they're the same way in Final Fantasy. In whatever year this is, it's probably year X minus 2 of Moon Time. Oh my god. Is this a little kitty cat?
What's
that?
Taking a little stroll? How come you're all alone? You must be hungry. Yeah, that's what I thought. Hold on a sec. I'll find you something. Gotta come up with some cat food.
Could always buy some.
Or we could fish for some.
Excellent idea. Let's go.
Did you hear that? Ah! That was terrible!
I love cats. I love the little cat noises. Man, if there's some sort of a cat uprising, and somehow, I don't know, maybe the plants released some sort of a chemical like The Happening, and instead of killing people, the chemical made cats sentient, and extremely powerful and all-knowing. I would be their slave, man. I would do whatever they wanted. They're cute little meows. I'm done. You don't even need to indoctrinate me. You don't need to put me in chains. I'll do whatever you want. Which is probably why I'm a cat owner. Noctis can fish at docks around Lucius. Triangling a fishing spot, Nor's, what is that, Vanath? Vanath? Let's say Vanath Coast. Side quests are separate adventures that do not progress the story. Check the side quest destination objectives in the quest menu. We don't need to progress the story right now. We'll progress the story soon. Alright. Let's see where we can fish. Oh my god, that's so cute. Ugh, I love cats. Okay. Well, I mean, sometimes I love cats. Most of the time I love cats, but sometimes, you know, they're just dicks. They bite you for no reason. That's when I don't love them. In Galden, Noctis comes upon a hungry cat on the pier and decides to reel in a fish. All right, where do we reel in this fish? Oh, okay. We're on the wrong pier. We had to be on that pier over there. Yep. I got a cat. His name is Jeff, and yeah, I am his slave. Every single morning, I hear this in the door. And he won't stop. He won't stop knocking his little paws against the door until I open the door and I get him some food. Yeah, he's got me trained, all right. Cats have everyone trained that owns them. If you don't do what they want, hell, they don't care. They'll just keep wrecking your shit until they do. Another shell. Nice. It's actually a known fact that cats don't learn. You can try to keep them off counters, and you can think that you've taught them to stay off counters, but they'll just go when you're not looking. They'll just go when you're not home. They know when you leave.
Hey, Noct. That looks like a fishing spot.
Serious?
This will be our first time fishing outside the Crown City.
Wonder what you can catch out here.
Only one way to find out.
You've discovered a fishing spot. Here, Noctis can indulge in his favorite pastime. Choose where to cast your lure with L, and the marker will indicate when the fish are near your target. Alright, I've fished plenty in Animal Crossing. See if we can get it on. Check the mini-map to find a good spot, and press X to cast your lure. Okay. Looks like this could be a good spot right here.
You might be handier with a rod than a sword.
Thanks, Gladiolus. Move your lure by pressing R2 to reel it in and tilting L to work the rod. Okay. One day when I was fishing, around 7 or 8 years of age, I caught like 15. No joke. This isn't a fisherman's tale. I caught like 15 pufferfish in a row, which, you know, pufferfish, that's not exactly what you want to catch. I was hoping to catch some rainbow trout that day, but I caught 15 pufferfish, literally, and I had to toss them all back. Because I had no use for pufferfish. I did catch a rainbow trout a little later on in the day. It was within the proper regulations for me to keep it, but I gave it to somebody else on the pier because they're going to use it to feed their dog or something. Hope that doggo liked it. And we're not getting any fish. I think I'm doing this right anyway. I just wait until the fish takes the bait, right? Pulls down the bobber a little bit and then I reel it in. Oh, wait. You see that? We got little fishies. Hey, little guy, you see that? Bobber's right there. Yeah, he's going for it. No, he's not. Shit. What about if I take a little closer? I'm a little closer than that. Now, in real life, a lot of movement from the bobber's gonna scare the fish, but I don't know if that happens in Final Fantasy World. Come on. I know you want this. Just take a little bite. Just a little tiny bite, that's all. Come on. Nah, he's not going for it. Let's find another location. You have to move your bobber. Really? Alright. I moved it a little bit. I guess I didn't move it enough. Let's try it again. Let's reel it in nice and easy. The fish is eyeing the lure. Entice it to bite by mixing up your reeling speed. Oh, okay. Looks like these are pretty brave fish. Gah! Fish is no longer eyeing the lure. You know what? Gladiolus is complimented. Oh my god! Look at the size of that thing! His compliment is no longer sounding like a compliment. You see that? That was a huge fish. He was a little to the right. Let's see if we can get him. This thing was massive. Almost looks like a prehistoric fish. I mean, we are on a world that's not Earth, so who knows? Everything here is pretty much alien to us. There he is. The big one. Oh yeah. He's not eyeing the lure. He's close, but he doesn't want anything to do with it. I think I still know where he is. Man, that cow would be so happy we found this huge, huge fish for him. Damn, man. These fish want nothing to do with us. Alright, let's try it again. Just stand a little further out. There we go. Right. Find the lure. Wait, what? Alright, so they say to mix it up by changing the reeling speed, but as far as I can tell, there's only one speed. No matter how softly I push the trigger. Entice it to bite by mixing up your reeling speed, yeah. Whoa, we got a bite! Come on, baby! Oh, he's gonna get away. No, he's not! We got this! Come on! Press R to do, reel in the fish and wear down his stamina. When the fish is all out of stamina, you can pull it up. Sounds like a plan. Alright, let's keep this up. He's coming in pretty nice. Not bad. don't let the line break. When the tension meter starts blinking red, stop reeling and give it some slack. Okay. I think we're starting to get the hang of this thing. Let's keep reeling him in. All right, tension's going in the red. So far, so good. Whoa, 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 whoa! He's put up a little bit of a fight. We got this, we got this. It's getting a little tricky now.
Huh. Great job, Noct.
Glowing barrelfish. And we absolutely crushed our previous fishing records.
This is our first fish.
The color of a fish on the mini-map indicates its yield. Yellow dots represent edible fish. Oh crap, was that a prize fish? The rarer the fish, the better the ingredient or treasure it provides. By honing Noctis' fishing skill and acquiring new tackle, you can reel in real whoppers and reap the rewards. I think that we caught a non-edible fish because none of these are yellow dots on the mini-map, but I hope the cat will still eat it.
Wait, what's that?
Oh, I thought the fish was on the pier. Guess it's in our pocket. Alright, wait. Oh, an edible. Yep, that wasn't edible. Alright. Gotta try it again. We got the hang of it now, though. See, I don't see any yellow dots, but I'm gonna assume that maybe if the crosshairs are yellow, the fish could be edible. Glowing fish aren't edible. Let's remember that. Looks like she's glowing fish over here. I'm gonna recast it. No, don't say that, man. Don't say the cat's gonna die. Little kitty's gonna be just fine. He's a little kitty cat. He can survive off dirt, right? He eats grass, right? Cows have a bunch of different stomachs. One of those stomachs is to process grass exclusively. Unfortunately, I don't think cats have that stomach, so we better hurry up with this fish. Alright, I'm thinking that maybe if a fish doesn't eye your lure immediately, you should recast. Man, this is harder than fishing in real life. Possibly because most fish in real life that you'll catch are usually edible. Especially by an animal. Man, we aren't having any luck today. You know what I just realized? It's nighttime. It's nighttime, we gotta come back to this. I'm assuming that you have different fish depending on the time of the day. So, maybe you just get the glowing fish at night and we don't want the cat to glow, alright? We don't need this guy lighting up like a damn Christmas tree. Now biting a giant Tevely and Galdon Tevely and more.
I'm gonna reel in a monster.
He's got it bad.
Yeah, I don't know about that monster part, man. Maybe just a tiny glowing fish. Alright, let's go for the other quest. A gentleman's agreement. We gotta go out a little bit for this. We'll take the car. So we got this Italian-Japanese reporter pretty boy that's been bullying us. He's basically made a threat that the boat isn't going to come. We're not going to be able to catch the ferry if we don't do this favor for him.
They've been on the move all night. Perhaps we should find a place to rest nearby.
No, we don't need to rest. Not right now, anyway.
I won't stop you. But there's a thin line betwixt bravery and stupidity.
Honestly, he's not wrong, but I'm gonna ignore his words of wisdom.
Time to go.
Yo guys, I know the cat's hungry, but there's just not much I can do about that right now. The guilt that I have is immeasurable, trust me.
Noct, you could use a break. I'm happy to take over.
Shit. All right.
Mother, she's all yours.
Nah, happy to oblige.
Get a cave sometime.
All right, Ignis. I need you to take us to whatever this place is. What is this? I think it's just a mineral deposit.
Wait a second. Wait, can he?
Oh, I think we have to drive manually. I don't see any parking spots nearby. Maybe it expects us to walk. We're gonna have to. Oh, wait. Quest location, of course. Of course, there we go.
Shall we then?
Hit it, Specs.
Maybe Sid was right about your lack of dignity.
You're one step above delivery boy.
Royal rank carries little weight outside the Crown City.
Glad it's not weighing me down.
Yeah, I could tell that nobody really cared that Noctis is a prince. You'd think, even outside the royal city, people would care about royal stature. Guess it's kind of a good thing that they don't. Maybe that makes their world a better place. Probably not.
We're almost there. The not-so-average gamer asks, can I ask you dating advice? Yes, you may. Listen. If she asks you to run an errand, maybe taking a package that she's already put in your trunk, and she asks you to take it to another motel, don't ask about the motel. Don't ask about how she got in your trunk or why it's in your trunk and why she was so assuming. Just do it. Also, if she asks you to look for some guy that's holed up in a shed,
in the right spot?
Kill all the demon dogs.
Let's scope it out.
Another tip. Have a bomb-ass car like this one. Apparently, they made this car in real life. Audi manufactured the real-life variant.
But that was expensive.
Alright, let's get these minerals. That's kind of rude of us. We just parked in the middle of the road. Yeah. You realize we were going to get back in the car, so we just drove around. That's probably a good idea.
This is a pretty beautiful place for the middle of nowhere.
How big is this game? Well, Nathan, I'm not sure if
this will make a fine paint.
This is accurate, but apparently people have data mined the demo of the game. Now that the game's out, we should have an official statement, but people data mined the demo of the game, which said that this game was far, far larger in terms of the open world space than The Witcher 3 was.
OMG. We're supposed to get near that thing?
Pipe down before you wake it up.
Okay. That's either Last Guardian big, or that's like prehistoric, it's gonna eat us big. And I'm not gonna bet that it's the former. Jesus. Oh my god, look at that beak.
Yeah, this thing could eat us like we're little pebbles.
Gah!
Just be quiet. I think it sees us. I think it still sees us.
Oh man.
Looks like some sort of a demon vulture.
Can I just warp over there?
Alright, I'm not gonna take any chances. We're just gonna wait. Just gonna wait a second. Just wait a second. And let's move.
Just a little bit. Oh my god. Oh my god, that's big.
Oh, that thing looks mean. Yeah, we could. Whoa, that's its tail. That is one ginormous tail. If we could barely take demon dogs, I don't want to tussle with a demon vulture. Giant demon vulture.
Okay, you know what I just realized? This is Chocobean. Birds love this stuff. I mean, he might be big, but he's still a bird.
Uh,
We got the garnet stone, but I don't see the choker being around. You know, let's just get out of here. Let's just get out of here. Maybe my friends have some choker bean on them. I almost thought it said, give the dino the stone. But we're not giving this thing the stone, we're giving Dino the stone. Can we just jump? It's not that far down. Yeah. Oh shit. Wait, are we dead? No, we are not dead. And it's alive! My god. That's actually pretty majestic. It's got neck wings. Wow. All my friends are dead. I'm so sorry. That was not very princely of me, was it? Let's get back to the car. We got the stone, we got all we need. It's time to get out of here. Pretty epic music, too. I feel like that's not the last time I'm going to see that thing. Oh, good. You guys are alive. And, of course, Gladiolus is the one that's the healthiest. Man's a tank. Could take anything. I almost thought it was going to be boss battle time. Luckily, it wasn't.
Wait. Where is this? This loading screen's on a coast, but look at that. It's like a city amongst crystals.
Here we are.
We made it.
We made it. It was a couple hundred feet, man. It wasn't that far. Oh, you're talking about the bird. Yeah. Yeah. Somehow we evaded a boss fight and we weren't eaten. Consider that a victory. Any chocobos? Nope. Still unavailable. I would totally use an oversized chicken instead of a car. And we got a nice car too, so that's saying a lot. Yeah, I'm pretty sure if that bird shit on our car as it was flying away, it'd probably crush the car.
Oh, I'm so sorry, little kitty. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Will you eat the glowing fish at least?
Oh my god, he's breaking my heart.
Please tell me we can finish the quest after we give Dino the stone, because I feel really bad about
Welcome
that.
To Golden Key.
Thank you, staff. What an interesting voice this guy has. Alright, would you imagine this guy has a voice like,
my name's Vin Diesel.
Or,
Welcome to Golden Key. We're so happy to adhere to your service. Mr. Prince, is it? It's just such a pleasure to have you at Golden Key. Please, why don't you check out our many amenities here at Golden Key? We have beautiful seafood and
Italian mafia reporters. They're gonna bully you into taking stones away from giant dinosaur birds.
Yeah, I'm not too keen on this place's service.
I mean, they got decent food, all right, but they don't keep out the undesirables, or even Italian mafia.
Kid, sorry for giving you such a hard time. I just had to get my hands on this, even if it meant blackmail. You understand, don't you?
No.
You see, I'm a reporter by day and an amateur jeweler by night. This elusive little beauty's gonna become a masterpiece. To make it up to you, I'll share a little scoop. That special coin you got? It commemorates the Oracle's ascension. That guy was tossing them out to everyone. Must have picked them up back in Niflheim. And speaking of freebies, here's one from me. Come back if you want to buy more.
I doubt a souvenir like that could make its way into the hands of an ordinary citizen.
Oh well, it's our pocket change now.
Let's learn from history and book a place this time.
What's all this about the port?
As promised, I'm in the process of securing your ferry tickets right now. Told you, I'm a man of integrity. Should be smooth sailing from here. So let me know when you're ready to ship out.
I admit I didn't expect Dino to secure us a ship.
Well, must be pretty connected if he can pull some strings around an imperial embargo.
Yeah, that guy's one artful artisan.
So this Dino guy, is he the voice of Meowth? Because it sure sounds like it.
You guys ready to set sail?
Once you proceed, you'll be unable to return for some time. Are you certain you wish to continue?
No, unfortunately.
I'm not trying to rush you or nothing. Come back when you got everything in order.
Appreciate that,
Neil. He gave us one of his pieces, just like that.
Maybe he'll make some more for us.
Yeah, for a pretty gill.
Worth it for a one-of-a-kind accessory.
He may have come off as flippant and forceful, but I sense Dino is honest and hard-working at heart.
Huh. Sounds like he and I are two peas in a pod.
Nah. He's a hell of a lot sharper than you are.
And he's got a lot more substance, too.
You know what? Actually, we are going to continue right now. I'm going to make a quick save before we do. We got about 20 more minutes in this live stream. I didn't realize that we've only been streaming for an hour 40. Not bad. You know what? Let's go on an adventure.
Already? The ship won't arrive till tomorrow. How about you find a place to spend the night?
Oh. I thought he was asking if we were ready.
I'm all sticky and gross.
Woohoo! Bath time!
Is there a reason the screen was black doing all that? You know what? At this point, I'm afraid to find out. Just don't even show me. Offensive, A+, finesse, B, time, B. This wouldn't do too bad. Hey, yeah, that's not a bad room. Looks pretty nice. It's got a good view, too. Hey, awesome! We made it up to level 7. Unfortunately, the cat won't make it to age 7. Or even 2. Depending how old he is. Yeah, I can totally understand why Gladiolus' survival went up to level 2. I mean, he did take like 99,000 damage from that giant bird. Oh shit, yo, we got pictures.
Yeah, that's a good one. Friendship.
I'm gonna save that. I like that. Looks like some fashion magazine.
Damn,
yeah, man.
This is a really good shot.
I made sure I got the regalia's good side.
Good side? Damn it, man. The entire car is its good side. The thing is it's a thing of beauty is what it is. Yo! I'm gonna share a little tweet on our road trip. Road trip bros! Damn, this is taking a while to type out. you don't feel how long it takes to type something, unless you're doing it live in a live stream. Oh, that's not. Where is, oh, there you are. Elusive little comma. Hello, stream fan. There we go. Little memory immortalized. I remember when God of War, the remastered edition of God of War 3 came out. It had a feature just like this where you could take pictures. And you can remember your adventures via those pictures. And it also had a share function, just like this. I like that. And I like this. I think that's fun. Doggo! Yes, I'm saving that photo. Once we got... that's secret. Can't save that. Yeah, why not? Five Nights at Freddy's Crow Diner. Final Fantasy 15. It's got a beer! That's pretty good, too. That one's pretty nice. Hey.
Not bad.
You got some explaining to do with this picture. Why would you take a picture of this guy? Honestly. We should probably save it. Just so we know who he is in the future. And this son of a bitch. Wanted for blackmail. Have they ever made a keyboard for the PlayStation 4? I'm talking about the kind that plugs into the bottom of the controller. Back in the Xbox 360 days, which surprisingly this game is on the Xbox One, by the way. It used to be that this game was going to be a PlayStation 3 exclusive, but not anymore. Eventually, it's rumored it may be
come to PC?
I think if it comes to PC, that would be a wonderful thing.
I don't know if any other Final Fantasy games aside from MMORPGs have been on PC. Even those, I'm not sure.
Oh, USB keyboards work on PS4.
Do USB microphones, I wonder? Now that would be useful.
Still, I'd almost just rather have a tiny little proprietary keyboard I can plug into the controller.
Red Wedding.
Hey, morning.
Oh, shit.
Where's Specs?
Should be back any minute now.
Why are they looking at me like I just screwed their girlfriends? They looked pissed.
What's that look for?
It's in all the papers.
What is?
Insomnia. False.
What? This is your idea of a joke?
I need you to calm down so I can explain.
I'm as calm as I'm gonna get.
There was an attack. The Imperial Army has taken the Crown City.
As treaty room tempers flared, blasts lit the night sky. When the smoke about the Citadel had cleared, the King was found dead.
No, wait. Hold on.
We had no way of knowing.
What? Knowing what?
That the signing was last night. That insomnia...
But the wedding! Alticia!
I know. That was the plan. Yet the reports of the invasion are all the same. How could every headline in the kingdom be wrong?
Lies.
If only.
What else do we know? Well, then we can't be sure until we see it with our own eyes.
And that means we go back to Insomnia.
Might not be safe for us there.
Might not be safe for us here.
Turn back.
Yeah.
Hell. I don't know how to react to something like that. I mean, the king's dead, the city's fallen. You're not getting married to some cool chick that's also an oracle? Seriously, though, this is, wow. I mean, just put yourself in his shoes, right? Like, here you are, going to save your kingdom by getting married. There's a treaty that's gonna be signed, peace is gonna fall throughout the lands. And then, as soon as you leave, about a day later, your city falls. King is dead. Red Wedding.
ill tidings. Head to the Insomnian border.
I hope everyone's okay.
A lot of good hoping's gonna do.
You mustn't lose faith.
Really? Can faith stop a fleet of Imperial dreadnoughts?
Just give it a rest.
My old man had plenty of faith.
Enough.
The Empire lied. They betrayed us.
Conjecture gets us nowhere. We're searching for truth.
All you'll find are lies.
Oh, shit.
Like that ceasefire.
Should we be worried about those? They're not gonna attack us, are they? If they know who we are, they were.
Look at the size of those things.
Imperial dreadnoughts. They transport soldiers, namely the Magitech infantry.
The robots?
Mass-produced humanoid weapons of warfare, to be more precise.
Doesn't look like they'll be signing that peace treaty.
It's a good thing we're hidden for now. This car is pretty fancy.
Up ahead.
Yeah, I think they may know.
They've set up an inspection point.
If the road ahead's blocked, then we find a way around.
Yeah, this doesn't look suspicious. What, are they just gonna let us bypass the inspection point? Oh my god, they are. You know, they should really watch this dirt road over here, or maybe pulled up the inspection point a little bit so it covered all the roads.
Let's make a detour. There ought to be a decent vantage point up ahead.
I don't want to leave the car, but we don't have much of a choice. We may be able to find another way around. After we get a good clearance.
There they are.
Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. Scrap heaps are gonna wish they had a treaty to protect them.
These things are pretty weird. They look like they're human. Obviously, they're not. Alright, let's show these things a thing or two. Crap, we're in stasis. Gotta fall back. Nice. I don't see any restore points. We're just gonna have to push forward. Alright, here we go. Excellent. Unfortunately for us, these guys have machine guns, which means we can't let up, not for a second. So far, we got some pretty good dodges, but we can't keep this up forever. Crap. Just got a few more. Let's go in for another warp strike. Beautiful hit, I think that's all of them. No, we got one more. He didn't stand a chance. Alright, so we're doing great with time and great with offense, but finesse, we need some work. Finesse has to do with, well, obviously our style and also the ease of which we do things. We'd better help out Prompto soon. He's gonna need some health, but not yet. Right now I think a potion would be a waste. No survivors. Hey, A+, Andy. Gotta work on our blocks a little more. Still, we don't have any time to lose. These little tiny fights may be all well and good, and they're pretty fun, but we literally have a kingdom hanging in the edge of balance.
We
and it's about to tip.
Imagine what it's like inside.
We should seek a vantage point. The hill.
Yeah, you're right about that.
It's any place we can warp to. You know what? Warp strike. God, almost got us up there. There we go. Vantage point. We're gonna fight this battle with as much teamwork as we possibly can. As soon as it's available to do so, anyway.
Alright, we're almost ready, we're almost ready.
Beautiful. Alright, nice hit, not too bad. Wait, what is that? What is that thing? Magitek Axeman. Yeah, that sounds dangerous. Let's go for a warp strike. Surely there's only so much he can withstand. Awesome. You know what, I got a new plan. We'll utilize some magic against these guys. So, things obviously have weaknesses, depending on what type of a thing it is. If it's organic or if it's inorganic, like these mechanized beings, they gotta be weak to something. Question is, what are these robots weak to?
I'm gonna craft some elemency. Let's see. We got lightning, fire, and ice. I'm gonna say these guys are weak to ice. We only have one more flask, so let's make it count. Well, let's make it powerful, too. We'll use 30. Alright, not bad.
Alright, let's fall back a little bit. We don't want to get caught in this blizzard. Hopefully my teammates do the same. Crap, they're taking a little bit of damage. But the machines are taking a lot more than we are. It's time to use the fire elemental blade. This blade looks pretty awesome. It's absolutely enormous. And it's the blade that we found at the beginning of the game. It's really slow, however, so we gotta be a little more cautious with our attacks. And we are not being cautious enough. So I'm gonna fall back on that warp point.
Crap, we can't use the potion up here. You know what?
We're not dead yet. Although Prompto is.
Alright, Prompto's good to go.
I'm not gonna worry about taking any potions. We'll do that later. Right now, we'll just focus our efforts and bring these guys down.
Just finish them off with a little bit of teamwork.
Nice. That's another Magitek craft. He's got a few more. Fantastic.
One hit, one kill.
Weapons marked with a plus can be remodeled. Take your arms to Hammerhead and ask Sid to upgrade them.
Looks like we're going back to Hammerhead at some point.
Suspended in light of recent developments. Moreover, in the wake of the news of King Regis's death, we've now received word that Crown Prince Noctis and the Oracle Lunafreya have also been pronounced
dead.
Keep it on. Don't bother!
It's not funny.
Outside the city, with no way back in.
Makes sense.
Makes sense? Are you
serious? What about any of this makes sense? The news just told me I'm dead, along with my father and Luna.
Listen, I'm heading out to Hammerhead. About the king, it's true. If you're looking for the whole truth, you know where to find me. Get moving.
Right.
What did the Marshal have to say?
Said he'd be in Hammerhead.
And the king?
Alright, that complete screen is a bit too cheery for my taste. So the invading empire, their strengths are technology, right? Well, if they're so technologically advanced, don't they have cameras? I think that our heroes, or at least Noctis, should be a little more careful about how close he stands to those chefs. Shit, man. I don't think I'm gonna save that photo. That's just sad. Also rude to take a photo in that time. What was that when I just found out that my dad died? Chapter 2. No turning back. In a single night, the promise of peace has been broken. The Crown City along with it, putting their home behind them. The four friends set forth to find answers in Hammerhead. How many answers are they going to find in Hammerhead? I don't know if they're going to find too many.
In any case, YouTube fam, thank you for joining me for this adventure through Final Fantasy XV. I like this game. I really like this game. Now I feel like I've been missing out. Like, the past decade that I haven't been playing Final Fantasy, I've been missing out, haven't I? I've really been missing out. Shit. This is a good game series. I'm really enjoying this game, though. It's good to be back. Even though I was never really there in the first place, this is going to be the first Final Fantasy game that I finish. We had to find a way to repair this car before we really start Chapter 2. And I'm going to pause it right there because unfortunately... You know what? We're going to continue with this cutscene because I'm not going to leave you guys with blue balls or anything. But unfortunately, I can't stream too much longer because I still got some videos to make tonight, and I will be able to tell you soon. I can't tell you now, I can't say anything, but exciting things are happening. Exciting things that you guys are going to love, but can't tell you anything. And it's totally not me going to the Doritos headquarters to taste test the brand new Doritos flavor that is called Star Wars. It's supposed to taste like the inside of Darth Vader's helmet. I don't know if that's supposed to taste good, if it's supposed to taste bad, but anyway, seriously though, it's going to be fun. It's going to be really cool, but that means that I can't stream for my usual, like, hours and hours. Anyway, let's continue.
The power of kings.
Don't suppose the Crown's Guard is still active?
I would count on it. Not with the Marshal out here.
I wonder how things are in the city.
There should be reports before long.
Yeah, something this big can't go ignored.
And what about us? What do?
We make for Hammerhead now, and figure the rest out later.
Man, that would be such a shitty position to be in.
Got a message from my sister. She's with refugees bound for Lestalem.
Well, at least Iris is okay.
Yeah. Doesn't sound like everyone else was so lucky, though.
We'd best make haste. Noct won't be dead forever.
No going back. Only ways forward.
No going back. Let's go.
He's right about that. We're gonna have to battle that big demon at some point, aren't we? Yeah. That's gonna be an awesome battle. I'm assuming that's going to be the final battle.
Hey.
Glad y'all made it. No weather for driving, that's for sure.
Oh, thanks.
Where's Cor?
Left to see to business. And left y'all a message with Pawpaw.
Yeah?
Boss ain't sat still 1 second since he heard y'all were coming. Ain't never seen Pawpaw like this before. The pep's gone out of him like air from a tire.
Yeah, this would be like if the Nazis were invading. Imagine that. Alternate history. Germany decides to invade Russia earlier, right? They don't hit them in the dead of winter, so they don't have that disadvantage. Operation Barbarossa is a success. Germany wins the war. They drop a bomb on New York City. And they invade the United States of America. That's terrifying. And that's Wolfenstein. And also, the Man in the High Castle, which isn't as good as I was hoping it would be, but I'm just like an episode into it, so I shouldn't judge it so much. Let's see how Sid's doing.
Crystal and the King's Ring, what they've been after all along.
So all talk of peace was merely a pretext.
They played my father for a fool.
Don't kid yourself. Reggie wasn't born yesterday. Lucis got dealt a losing hand, and your old man played it the best he could. He saw this coming a mile away, and he wasn't gonna go down without a fight. In the end, though, well, it just wasn't enough. You need something else, you talk to Cor. I can't even remember the last time I saw Reggie. Feels like a lifetime ago.
That got sad. He sent his son away, knowing very well it'd probably be the last time he saw him. I don't know how I'd deal with that, as the father or the kid. Thank God it's just a video game and not our lives. Thank God we're not being invaded by technology Nazis. Wait. It says we need to speak to Sid at the garage, but we just did that. I don't really see any sad cutscenes again with sad music. No. See?
Cora left a message. Said he'll wait for you in the tombs. There to the northwest of here. That's a short ways past the outpost. Find that first.
Tombs, huh? Alright. Unfortunately, we're gonna have to leave that for the next adventure. Ladies and gentlemen, seriously, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for joining me. Thank you for adventuring with me through Final Fantasy XV. This has been awesome, and it kills me that I'm not going to be able to live stream it tomorrow. We got some videos coming up in the next few days, but as soon as I can, we'll be resuming the live streams. In fact, if you follow us on Twitter or even the YouTube channel, you'll be able to see when we schedule streams before they happen, and if you'll be able to make the adventure with us. Regardless, this has been one goddamn hell of a show, and I'm really excited to watch Kingsglaive and the anime that goes along with these four brothers in arms. Yeah, what are you doing all the way back there, Pop, though? Come on, get up here. Thank you guys for joining me for this adventure. I'm going to do some shout-outs to thank you for joining us for Final Fantasy XV. If you want to see more, if you want to continue these adventures, subscribe, leave a like. We do a lot of live streams, we do a lot of videos. Regardless, we have some very, very exciting things coming to this channel in the next few days, and I'm really excited to share that stuff with you guys. I can't wait until I can talk about it. And we also have some awesome videos in the meantime as well. I'm going to set up the shout-out timer, but if you guys are new, if you just joined our YouTube fam, let me know. We'll give you a special shout-out. Also, let me know where you hail from. If you hail from Eos, Australia, China, Japan, Mexico, let me know. All right.
Don't, put your street address or anything like that down.
Timer is starting now. Shout out to Christian Jacob! Shout out to Naomi Phoenix! Oh, by the way, excuse the sound of the microphone. We're going to be giving away some copies of Titanfall 2 and a special extra-large collector's edition of a life-sized pilot's helmet of Titanfall 2 in the near future. Like, the giveaways are starting within a week. We got 5 PS4 games to give away and a life-sized Titanfall helmet.
Commence the shoutouts! Shout out to
Alex Omaroso, who is new to the fam. He says he is so new to the fam. Welcome to the fam, Alex. Shout out to Zombie Hunter. Shout out to Isaac, who's from the United States. Shout out to Christian Summersill. Shout out to Craig Riches. Summersill, that sounds like a name for Final Fantasy. Shout out to Ambassador Alex Bell. Shout out to Annie Demo from Greece. Shout out to JH2187. Shout out to Mayu Neptune. Thank you for that tip, by the way. I like that sword a lot. Shout out to JH2187. Shout out to Father Axekeeper from Japan. Shout out to Michael Espinoza. Shout out to Gary Busey. How do we win Titanfall? Probably just by retweeting a tweet and then I verify that you're human. That's the easiest way I've found to do giveaways on YouTube so far. We may be doing special giveaways as well where you just battle me one-on-one. Like for the collector's edition. Shout out to Jack Ruby. Shout out to Tavon Williams. Shout out to Lee Hanfoy 2 from Australia. Oah! Throw some shrimps on the barbie, mate! Shout out to Hayden from the UK. Shout out to Ekenobi75 from Philly. West Side Philadelphia, born and raised, am I right, man? Shout out to Joshua Lloyd, who just subscribed. Welcome to the fam, Josh. Shout out to the best Darth Vader ever. Shout out to Aaron Elysia Dilodovico. I'm not beautiful enough to pronounce that beautiful name. I'm sorry about that. Shout out to GhostKiller1701. Shout out to Peter Jobson, Bacon on Everything, Malcolm J. Shout out to Smithy Gaming, shout out to Jason Lyrics, shout out to David Johnson, shout out to Caboose 135 Blue Team, shout out to Twizzler Dona Gaming, and shout out to Mr. Artiz Life 13 from DC. Shout out to Ronnie Christensen from Denmark, shout out to William Jeffries III, shout out to Yes Jim with that adorable kitty picture, shout out to Jack Ruby with that awesome shaggy pic. Yeah, man. Shout out to X-Spartacus. Shout out to Jonathan Flores. Shout out to Alvin Benter. Beef Incorporated. Preston Ratcliffe. Brooklyn Lee. Shout out to Craig Ritchie. Shout out to Edward Fannon. Shout out to Alvin Benter. Levon Kublava. Wubba-lubba-dub-dub. Shout out to Preston Ratcliffe. Shout out to Shane Suku. Shout out to Rico from the... Wait, he's not from the UK. His name's Rico UK, but he's from the Isle of Man. Damn. But you wish you were from the Isle of Bees, am I right? Shout out to Naomi Phoenix. Shout out to Jonathan Mazes, new to the fam. Welcome to the fam, Jonathan. Shout out to William Jeffries III, who is also new to the fam. Shout out to Gary Busey. Shout out to Cento Rica from California. Shout out to David Johnson. Shout out to Violet Moon. Shout out to Ronnie Christensen. Shout out to King PJ Happy. Shout out to MikeMan96, shout out to Cal, shout out to Christian, shout out to DJDragon31, PS3, PS4, and more. Shout out to PsychoTeddyBear888. Yo, I had that mask. That PsychoTeddyBear mask. I love that thing. Got it for like $5 at Target. It scares the hell out of cats. Shout out to Chansey Cheek. Shout out to Token Traveler. Shout out to Free. Shout out to MikeMan96. Shout out to Mr. Scott 101, and shout out to DG2, and that is just over the 2 minutes of shoutouts. 2 minute timer went off a few seconds ago, so you just have to take my word of that. Regardless, thank you for joining me for Final Fantasy 15. We had a nice road trip. Well, technically, yes, we did have a nice road trip, and then we had a far darker, far sadder road trip directly thereafter. In any case, it's been a goddamn pleasure, guys, and I'm really excited for the next adventure that we have together, and also to share this exciting news as soon as I can. But until that time, game massively, and I hope you have an awesome night, or morning, or afternoon, wherever you are in the world. Take care, guys. I'll see you soon.